In this illustration, we intend to simulate strengthening of reinforced concrete slab using CFRP in the Abaqus software. Or in other words, we intend to simulate the concrete slab reinforced with rebar and CFRP in the Abaqus software. The length and width of concrete slab is 3 meters and an axial load with an amount of 98 kilonewton will be applied to the concrete slab. In this picture, you can observe the carbon fiber reinforced polymer, CFRP, along with the rebars as well as supporters. From here, select beam and truss and continue. Here, I will enter cross-section area equal to 0.0001304 and continue. Here, I will click on assign section, select rebar and done and OK. From here, displacement, select these two columns, copy and paste them here. Damage parameter is a number between 0 to 1. And if the damage parameter is equal to 0, it would imply that the concrete has not been damaged. And if that is equal to 1, it means that the concrete has been totally damaged. The compressive stress in the fiber direction is a negative 1240 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. The tensile stress in the transverse direction is 41 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. Compressive stress in the transverse direction is negative 170 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. CFRP sheet is composed of two layers. The thickness of each layer is 0.5 millimeter. Well, I will select CFRP from here, enter the thickness of the first layer as 0.5 millimeter, enter the angle between the fibers and x-axis as 0 degree. Again, select CFRP from here, select this point, and then this one, and OK. I will click on Translate Instance, select this part, done, enter the start of the translation vector as 000 and the end of that as 01.3 meters and 0. And OK. Click on Translate Instance, select the rebar, done. First, select this point and then this one, and OK. And the offset equal to 0.2 meters, and OK. Here, select Static General, continue. The analysis would be done in nonlinear form. Tick on Damage Initiation Criteria option. Tick on Failure Measure Components option and OK. Create Boundary Condition. From here, select Displacement Rotation, continue. I will select this reference point, done, and close all boundary conditions of displacement for it, and OK. I click on Boundary Condition Manager, edit, tick off U3 option, and so in this manner, this part would be allowed to move directed towards Z axis. Click on seed part, enter the rough size of meshing equal to 0.04 meters and OK. Then I'll click on mesh part. From here, I select damage T, and you can observe the tensile damage of the concrete. Actually, the elements having been distinguished with red color are the areas where the concrete has been damaged. Here you can observe the rebars. I will select all of the rebars from here, and you can observe the stress contour in the rebars. From here I will select CFRP sheet, and it can be observed. Here we intend to evaluate Sci-Hill, Sci-Wu and Azi-Sci-Hill failure criterion, which are used for composites. First, I will select Sci-Hill failure criterion. According to this criterion, if the quantities of Sci-Hill is lower than 1, the composites will not sustain damage and failure. And if Sci-Hill quantities are higher than 1, the composites will sustain damage and failure. As you can observe here, Sci-Hill quantities are lower than 1. So the composites will not sustain damage and failure. In the next step, I will select Sci-Wu failure criterion. According to this criterion, if the quantities of Sci-Wu are lower than 1, the composite will not sustain damage and failure. And if the quantities of Sci-Wu are higher than 1, the composite will sustain damage and failure. As you observe here, Sci-Wu quantities are lower than 1, and so the composite will not sustain failure.